It is among the most difficult decision a grieving family must face, picking a cremation service. Consumer Watch reporter Julie Watts investigates a worst case scenario and questions why one company is still operating without a license in California.
This is a picture of Jake.
Lisa Colton treasures these photos of her son. He died at age 22 while skiing in Boulder, Colorado. But she says what happened after that devastating loss made the unbearable situation worse.
I wouldn't wish it on my worst enemy.
The Bay Area family searched the web to find a local cremation service in Colorado. They settled on Heritage Cremation Providers, advertised as family-owned and operated trusted cremation services in Boulder, a service they soon wished they hadn't trusted.
It was just horrifying.
First, there were invoice errors. The company referred to Jake, the deceased, by several different names, including the Williams family and Sarah White. Then the family says their phone calls went unanswered, they were charged extra fees, and finally, the unthinkable, Jake's ashes went missing.
They lost track of him for a week,
forcing the grieving mother to return home without her son. There are dozens of similar complaints and scathing reviews online about Heritage mix-ups, poor service, delays, and ashes held for ransom. The Better Business Bureau issued a warning about the company in Colorado, where Heritage says it's located. Unlike most states, it does not require a license.
They are not here.
However, an unannounced visit to the company's local address revealed no one from the company actually works there. It turns out the most trusted cremation services in Boulder is also the most trusted in San Francisco, San Jose, Berkeley, Palo Alto. The list goes on. They serve as a sort of body broker, collecting upfront fees from grieving families, then subcontracting actual services to local funeral homes.
They're misrepresenting themselves as a local business.
Joya Emmert of the California Cemetery and Funeral Bureau says they received numerous local complaints about Heritage, which is operating without a license in California. The Bureau issued a cease and desist, but when we called the company,
so you are licensed in California,
they were still clearly operating and assured they were licensed here in the state.
What can you do for a company that doesn't have a license, is ignoring your cease and desist, and is still operating?
There are further actions that are being looked at.
California is one of five states that's taken recent action against the company so far, but the father-son duo behind Heritage has a long history with the law. The elder, Joseph Damiano, was arrested in 2002 for operating a crematory without a license and bringing bodies to Lynn University for embalming practice without the knowledge or permission of the families. His son, Tony, was later barred from the funeral business in Florida for 10 years.
So you do work for the company, though, right?
In a phone call, Tony Damiano told us he had no comment, but previously told our Miami affiliate the company will continue to serve families that need their services. Something that 2 years after her ordeal continues to torment Lisa.
I can't stand the thought of another parent going through this.
The California Cemetery and Funeral Bureau advises against searching for funeral services online. They suggest asking a local trusted funeral home for recommendations for things like cremation services. And they also advise that you always check the company has a valid license by searching the Bureau's website. In the newsroom, Julie Watts, KPIX 5.